Good morning, Northern California. I'm Edie Lambert, and here's what's happening. Park rangers are closely monitoring El Capitan at Yosemite National Park after 8 large rock falls in 2 days. One man was killed and his wife injured as the first huge boulder crashed down on Wednesday. The largest rock fall so far was yesterday afternoon, and another person was injured in that one. Here's what one climber saw.
That rock fall was a full order of magnitude bigger than the last rock fall. The rock slide went all the way down to the road past the Zodiac pullout.
Right into the Merced River.
Right into the Merced River. You can't even see Half Dome because of the mist. Absolutely unbelievable. We couldn't see it. We were on the summit. We are all safe.
Northside Drive leaving the valley is now closed because of all the boulders and debris.
In the weather, another good-looking day. However, today is going to be somewhat changeable. We'll see a lot of sunshine mixed with just a couple of clouds. Temperatures by noontime will be in the upper 70s. That's cooler than yesterday. And by 5 o'clock, we'll be in the mid-80s. So mid-80s with some afternoon clouds. For the weekend, however, temperatures will stay in the mid-80s. I think Saturday will also have some north breezes. It'll turn somewhat windy by Monday. And again, it's those dry north winds with highs in the upper 70s. But as we head through next week, you'll see while temperatures will be on the cooler side, still no sign of any rain. Edie?
It looks beautiful. Mark, thank you. We are learning more about the murder of a Yuba City soldier. One of the suspects in Shadow McLean's death pleaded guilty to multiple charges, and he claims it was murder for hire. Charles Robinson says McLean's ex-husband promised to pay him $10,000 to kill McLean last year. Her body was found months later in Tennessee. The ex-husband, Sergeant Jamal Williams McCray, has not yet gone to trial. Here's another reason to check your credit card statements. Police found several skimming devices at a Sacramento gas station. This happened at the Stop and Shop at 35th Street and Folsom Boulevard. Customers noticed hundreds of dollars in charges after filling up, then reported it to police. The gas station owner says a technician found several credit card skimming machines in those pumps. Police are now holding them for evidence. Investigators have not yet identified the thief. Here are three things happening today. There's a new push for affordable housing. Today, Governor Brown will join state lawmakers to sign a series of bills to increase the supply of less expensive living options in California. The 11th annual Sacramento Horror Film Festival kicks off today. That's at the historic Colonial Theater in Sacramento, and it runs through tomorrow. And we're just a few hours away now from Friday Night Football. This is week 5, and our game of the week is the Intercom Tigers hosting the Yuba City Honkers. Join us for all the high school excitement tonight at 11 on KCRA3. And thank you for joining us. You can get the latest headlines anytime you're on the go with the KCRA3 app.